And good evening, and thanks for watching Denver 7. I'm Ann Trujillo.
And I'm Shannon Ogden. And tonight, Colorado Parks and Wildlife is defending the decision to euthanize a mule deer that attacked a woman.
But others say that doe was just defending its young and should have been relocated rather than put down. Denver 7's Megan Lopez is going 360.
Call it a hazard of living in Colorado.
This morning we had a cyclist that ran into a doe.
Moments when humans and wildlife come into contact. There can be happy endings.
We were able to save one of the fawns.
Other times there are not, like the case of an 85-year-old woman who was walking her dog in Craig when she came upon a doe and her fawn and startled it.
Caused her attack.
The woman was injured and the doe was put down. Tonight we're going 360 on that decision. Hear from Colorado Parks and Wildlife, who says it tries to protect animals when it can, but that there are instances when the animals are too aggressive. A conservation group who says it's not the animal's fault and that state policies need to change. And hikers who say humans need to do a better job of respecting boundaries.
It's a tough balancing act sometimes.
For Jason Clay from Colorado Parks and Wildlife,
we have a very strong responsibility to keep the public safe.
This was an unfortunate instance.
It's the darkest days of any of our wildlife officers that they have on the job is when they have to put them down. They don't enjoy that aspect at all.
However, CPW says this doe was unusually aggressive, out of its habitat, and attacked a woman who wasn't trying to interact with it.
These things are going to happen.
They understand that.
And know certain times of year, animals are going to be more aggressive.
And there are times when they don't euthanize, like a recent moose attack in Nederland.
That was a case of some, you know, normal behavior a little bit, defending its calf in its natural environment.
But people need to remember.
Wildlife are just that, they're wild, they're unpredictable.
So we're starting to encroach on more and more wildlife habitat.
Meanwhile, Samantha Bruger with conservation group Wild Earth Guardians says it's not the animal's fault.
However, the doe is acting like a doe would act.
She thinks wildlife agencies are too quick to kill.
Wildlife services really employs euthanasia and killing first, especially in human conflict situations.
And says it's time to revisit state policies.
I think that wildlife management in Colorado needs to adapt with the growing population and with the best available science that's come out.
To find a way to protect both humans and animals as more development happens. Out on the Apex Trail in Golden today,
I've come across coyotes, deer, and elk.
A reminder to hikers and bikers that they're leaving their territory and entering the animals.
You know, we're kind of in their world.
People we spoke with say they do their best to respect wildlife and
just remember you're in their home and that they're going to possibly feel protective.
And know that we're not in a zoo and, you know, there's the ability of getting hurt.
So for them, the key is,
I think, to steer clear of them as much as possible.
And when the animals come into our territory,
discourage their coming into more public spaces.
Like not feeding them so they don't make a habit of coming back. Despite their differences, everyone we spoke with agreed that education is the key to coexistence.
Part of the responsibility that comes with living in this state is knowing how to live with wildlife responsibly.
Megan Lopez, Denver 7.
And we know this is a touchy topic, so we want to know what you think. Email us your thoughts at 360@thedenverchannel.com, and we may share those comments with you tomorrow at 6.